face, because quite often he does that. Fitz will get us underway at the Peter McCarver standing
him and believing that he can make a difference in the PSL. It's not usual.
No, it isn't, but yeah, if you good enough, then you're old enough as well. And Baraka benefiting Narrows in the 2-1 victory away in KwaZulu-Natal against Abafana Bestende. And a victory that really has maybe served as a bit of a launching pad after that victory against Mamelodi Sundowns as well to Baraka's premiership aspirations of staying outside that relegation zone. Somewhere where you don't want to be relegated to the National First Division. And they find themselves having lost against Ubuntu yesterday and 6 losses in a row at the bottom of the NFD, former Platinum Stars. Incredible. Come from Baraka. They'd love to be able to score one here and really put the Bidvest side under some pressure, and they go straight for goal, and that's fantastic. Absolutely brilliant goal from Baraka. The fans will celebrate. And the
maybe not allowing the game to flow as it is right now. A little bit of a surprise that the tempo has not dropped in any way. I know it's only just a few minutes into the game, but it's wonderful, because sometimes you find players just lowing down knowingly that this is a game that might spill off
this sort of blazing heat. Yeah, one would have certainly thought it would have been a slower start to the match, but not so at all.
Baraka don't know, of course, how to slow down a game. Don't ask them to, from his days from the local football when he played for Kaizer Chiefs.
Cloud wide here to the former Jomo Cosmos Nabib Alexander, and he needs to be careful with any outbursts. Really seeing the referee showing no hesitation in going to the pocket. There's Carl Alexander again then. Looking wide for... But spoke about that during lunch, William.
Yes. Others obviously were saying that maybe the captain will look to a player that will sit a bit more. And I'm thinking to myself, not a chance, not Nanyane.
He goes beating Mamelodi Sundowns by 2-0. One must also bring into consideration that this is the third match in a row that Bidvest Wits are playing away from home. They played every single one of their matches away from home in this season's cup. That early is that you have so much more time to grab an equalizer and maybe even push forward for a victor. We saw that from Bloemfontein Celtic when they played against Bidvest Wits at the Bidvest Stadium on the 10th of November. Bidvest Wits led by a goal to nil. That Domingo free kick was also a beautiful thing. And then Celtic scored 2 goals.
But also considering that early means that your approach to the game will have to change a little bit, because suddenly you play with pressure whereby you'll need to play a bit. I can't help but think about this team. I'm talking Baraka. If you look at the average age, in fact, the average in the whole team is about 22. If you...
Nice give out. Goes back to Elvis Chipezeze. Looking for the long ball again. Knocked away by Tulani Flatswayo with the left foot. Well, they've kept the ball in play nicely here, have the clever boys. And they'll have to settle for a corner. It bins on the touchline and providing the music, and yeah, just very pleasant indeed. Now Tugamanja looking for some space here for the visiting. The reason why I bring up Mazaluke is because you and I were coming. From Goodman Moselle, but Baraka starting deep every single time. Touch from the man who created the corner in the first place. A space on the edge of the penalty area. The shot can't make its way through though. Lechlo Honolo on stage. We'll see Simon Murray coming, because Murray is a goal poacher of note, and he's going to certainly put Chipezeze under pressure.
Now look at that 48% on the defensive part of Baraka. I mentioned them, they're not being pressed. It means they're recycling the ball easily in their defensive half. It's not necessarily because Bidvest applying that much pressure.
Everton as well, played at Hellenic back in the day when it was a team like Hellenic in the Premier League. Olise Mankuku can't get the better of Bongi and Kosi Makume. Minutes and stoppage time away from half time at the Peter McCarver Stadium in Polokwane. Thanks for joining us on the Sunday afternoon. The Telkom knockout semi-final.
One of these on, for that first challenge by Dickinson to the back of Mukhachayo.
Playing the long ball suddenly, Baroka. Flick on from Dicker on field. Now a chance here for Chukwumanja. Hashim Domingo's pulled wide on the right-hand side. Hotto on the left. Offside against Bidvetsvets. Well, that's an impression. Thanks for an interception as well. Chukwumanja again. Forward by Nonyane. Cole Alexander wins it back. Motupa.
Send it cracking into the back of the net. Is what is banking on, basically. As long as you keep it in. Unlike the last one in the first half where he played it direct out.
And that's movement on the scoreboard.
The Cloud Carver is playing its part. If you look at the tempo with which Bidvest are playing now, that's much better. And this is what basically I think they're looking for. And as far as being able to get in the Bidvest side, that on paper you'll expect them to dominate. But I think we're beginning to see that ability right now.
They get caught offside on this occasion to the really lack of passing execution right now, and Gavin Hunt more animated than normal. We've had an hour of football in Polokwane. Morocco lead by that goal.
Suddenly I think they've just remembered that their team that are known to be able to play from the back, and beautiful constructional passes and lots of composure into the attacking.
Papiro, who was with Buju Cape Town FC last season, and he will come on for Jamandre Dickens, who I think has had a tremendous game today.
Injo saw a step forward to try and avoid that offside call. Almost with his first touch, nearly finding the back of the net.
What happens to Nonyane in that event? Looks like Clunty, well, he's going to play on the left-hand side. There's no doubt about that, but which part of the ground does he play on? Does he play in a forward role or more defensive?
Can build up very well under normal circumstances, but not now. It's all like long balls played forward in hope that will get to maybe Chivaviro, who I think is still fresh. But
oh, it's been an incredible match. I mean, wow, that miss from Dansane. Murray beaten in the air, and looks like one of the centre backs he's limping rather as a substitute. And this is a situation where the home side are going defensive because Darren Chalapiwa is going to make way on the right hand side. Pettis, here comes Lekolohonono Nonyani once again. Murray again misses out. Second ball pick up from Baroka, and now they have numbers around the ball. This is Madubanya. They've only used two of this. We are in second half stoppage time. 5 minutes have been added on. That's going to please Bidvest
to try and wind the clock down further.
Cole Alexander. And again, he can't thread the eye of the needle. Banged away anywhere will do by Bongi and Kosi Makume. They'll stand this an extra time. Well, only time will tell, because we now less than a minute away from full time in Polokwane. Domingo wonderfully blocked away